Upon my first encounter with a tightrope walker, I mistakenly assumed that the pole he was carrying was merely meant to heighten the thrill of the performance. I thought it was a tool to make his formidable feat look even more impressive. While watching another performance on television, I began to perceive the pole as a prop, perhaps employed for juggling or other tricks to add an extra element to the tightrope walking act. Many viewers might relate to these theories regarding why tightrope walkers carry a pole with them. While it's true that the pole does contribute to the theatricality of the act and may serve a double function for performers who incorporate juggling into their walk, it also serves a crucial gravitational function. The pole increases the walker's rotational inertia, assisting their balance as they tread the narrow rope. Moreover, the pole adds weight beneath the walker's center of gravity, further ensuring stability. This leads us to the somewhat esoteric concept of rotational inertia, also known as the moment of inertia. In layman's terms, it is a measure of an object's resistance to changes in its rotation. Everyday examples abound. Consider the ease with which we push open a screen door. This is due to its low rotational inertia. Or think of how a bicycle maintains balance while moving, thanks to the rotational inertia of its wheels. And let's not forget the perfect example of figure skaters. They pull their arms in to decrease their rotational inertia, enabling them to spin faster. The moment of inertia depends on more than just an object's mass, but also how that mass is arranged relative to the axis of rotation. Broadly speaking, objects with a mass that is further from their axis of rotation are harder to rotate or stop from rotating. Consider the example of a tightrope walker. The pole they carry, termed a balancing pole, increases their moment of inertia when held horizontally, minimizing their body's rotation around the rope. The pole's length is also important. Since a longer pole means better stability, as it disperses the combined weight of the walker and the pole across a larger area on the rope, distance from the pivot point, which is the walker's feet. Even if the walker begins to tip over, the rotational inertia caused by the pole means that more force is needed to rotate, thus giving the walker more time to correct their position. On top of increasing the walker's moment of inertia, the balancing pole lowers the walker's center of gravity. In general, any object with a lower center of gravity is typically more stable. This is why sports cars are designed with such low ground clearance. Tightrope walkers habitually hold the bar at or below waist level, which is near their center of gravity. Having additional weight below their center of gravity further grounds them, making their walk across the thin rope a bit less terrifying. As we've now discovered, the art of tightrope walking, far from a mere circus stunt, is deeply tied to physics. It's the perfect amalgamation of art and science, demonstrating how, with a thorough understanding of physical forces and their application, the seemingly impossible can be achieved.